town was bustling with life. Even at this late hour, perhaps the townspeople would have something interesting to share.
Stranger.
You're closer, Eden. Closer than you ever were. Come, find me.
I've heard that voice before. It feels familiar somehow. I must have dreamt it.
Had she, though? Well, it was impossible for me to confirm, since we narrators never got to see what's going on inside our characters' dreams. Third-person, omniscient narrator my eye.
Mr. Knight, Nerdaster, Geyser, Mainaster. house cards here. I literally can't.
Arrived even. Soon you will find your voice. Salutations, even. I am the visionary. And I you, or rather, I will. Time is never so linear. I have watched you for a very long time, and I knew you would come here, to me.
This all seemed a bit unlikely to even. Maybe this strange, floaty person was lying. I mean, probably he was.
Please, you're not the only one who can see things even can't. Never mind, even. I should not have addressed him. Time is short, so I will be uncharacteristically direct. I am one of the sacred card makers. There were 5 of us once. There are 5 still now. We used to make every type of card imaginable. Together, we cared for this part of random, this 5 Tropolis, until the Queen banned all dice, and with them the unleashing of creativity. Now, we are bound to do the Queen's bidding. With your dice, you have the power to defeat the Queen and set things right. The rules that have strangled random for years must be erased, and true randomness must return. But the future moves, changes. You are a crisis even, and an opportunity for both sides. I cannot see clearly through the rug weave, but I can tell you this. In order to defeat the Queen, you need A very special card. Find the other card makers, free them, and we will unite to make you a card that will shake the foundations of Sixtopia. We will make for you your dream card. Follow my vision to the second of the card makers, the painter. And take this. It might come in handy.
This is... Are you sure you don't need this?
A visionary does not need mere eyes to see more. Now go. I have interfered enough.
Right.
Visionary seemed credible. Well, even incredible. And yes, maybe he could see things that he shouldn't be able to. And yes, that was alarming. But Eva knew the difference between novelty and fear. She pushed on towards the painter. And Dicey had set foot in Five Tropolis. Here, in the magical heart of Random, is where the cards used to shape the very face of the world were made. But it had long since decayed into little more than a cold and dreary factory, used for purposes far less enchanting.
Yes. I'm busy. And I'm the king of freedom. Now leave me alone. I'm busy. Always busy. If just causes were all it took to win, we wouldn't be stuck here, kid. No scram. Listen well, because I'm only going to say this once. I can't help you. You know why? Because the Queen has already won. That means we lose, kid. We lost, and we lose, and we keep losing until she decides she's tired of winning, which is never. Oh, I've seen your coin before. Convinced that you're different. Oh, you're special. And that if you could just reach her, you'll fix it all. Heck, I've even helped. You know what happens? You lose hard. And I'm still trapped here, forced to paint mad inventions for the Queen instead of the magical cards I used to love. All that changes is that you die a little sooner than otherwise, and my heart breaks a little more. And I'm tired of it. So no, I'm not helping you. Now, if you please, scram! Dicey? Oh my, where did you find that? This changes everything. A moment, love. There. Perfection. I painted your dream card, child. Frankly, it was a joy to paint something other than a dreadful robot for once. Oh, there'll be heck to pay once the Queen finds out. But you're going to reach her before that happens, won't you? I know you will, love. Your dream card, it's now off to the gluer. He's next in line. An old colleague and a card maker. Perhaps the most important of all. Is there anything else you'd like to know, love? Then go, love. The gluer waits.
Well, the painter had done all she could. Now, even was off to the gluer, who, and I'm going to go out on a limb here, might be in a sticky situation himself. Even found herself moving ever closer to the darkened heart of Five Troublous. Wherever the gluer was, he was...
Dicey. I just suddenly felt weirdly alone. In a way I can't explain. If that makes sense. I'm lucky I have you.
Story took a much darker turn.
Whoa. I feel like someone just walked over my grave. I've got a bad feeling, Dicey.
The foolish girl was far from here. She knew she made a mistake. She felt like giving up. Forever.
I don't know what it is, Dicey. I just feel odd. Tired all of a sudden.
very tower. What was she even doing here? She should just go home and die.
I won't give up. I won't give up.
Was as beautiful as it was hopeless. And it underlined the one universal truth. Haven
could never defeat the Queen.
She'd sooner topple a mountain with her breath than succeed. The card makers had given her a hopeless task. And the fool's Sisyphean efforts, full of sound and fury, would amount to nothing. Was doomed. She should just give up and die right now.
I know, Dicey. I know. I won't give up. I promise.
Herself for fighting back almost as much as everyone else hated her too. Thank you.
suddenly even realized what an awful person she was. She decided to lie down and die right away.
Oh. I don't know, Dicey. Just a random bad mood, I guess.
Voices. I call it a talkie-walkie. I've heard lots of people through it. Now I get to hear you. There's a lot of twins, and people are happy and then sad and then happy and then sad again. So I'm gonna go out on a limb and say Toontown. I can see why you wanted to visit this place. It's great. The mayor's put up a statue of you, even. You and your dice, yeah. You look heroic. And everyone can flip their personalities whenever they want. It's crazy. It's kind of scary. But it's good, too. Oh, and the Upside Down? The Upside Down is an amusement park now. I guess, yeah. Anyway, guess what? I've decided to go on an adventure, like you! Horribly amazing, you mean? Yeah, it is. Only, I'm a little lost. Can you help me? Thanks, even. Okay, so, I've got a string I'm leaving behind for safety, so I can always get back to here. But I don't know where here is, and I don't want to be here. I want to be there. It's not home. That's where I want to be, back in Onecroft with my family. I'm going on the greatest adventure of all, the journey home. Lead me to adventure just like you led yourself, okay? Okay, so it's pitch black. I feel like I'm likely to be eaten by something. There's two paths here, left and right. To the left is, I want to say, growling. And to the right, I think there's sunshine. Which way do I go? Really? Okay. You don't want to help me? Okay. I guess I'll just follow my heart even. Hello? Even? Sure did. Barely. I keep almost dying. Anyway, Even, following my heart is bad, and I need an adventurer's heart to tell me what to do. So, I followed my string back to where I started. What do I do now? Lead me to adventure, okay? Okay, so, it's pitch black. I feel like I'm likely to be eaten by... No! There's a monster in there! Wrong call, even! I'm running back to the start! Okay, so... it's pitch black. Cool! Great. Okay. I'm walking, and I can see a bit better here. There's two paths, forward and right. Forward, there's clanking, and to the right, there's an eerie silence. Which way, even? Okay, this is fine, even. We're going on an adventure together. Okay, So I'm now in a clearing, and it's completely silent except for all these big spider statues? Only they're not statues. They're actual spiders. And they're moving towards me? Yeah! Okay. I'm running back to the start. Call me back, okay? Even? Hello? Even? Aw, I get it. I'm in favor of cool, mysterious quests myself. But, come back if you change your mind, okay? I'm pretty sure I'll still be, right here, wherever that is. So, I followed my string. Okay, so, it's pitch black. Cool! Great! Okay. Okay! Yeah! Okay! Hello? Even? Aw, so... Okay, so... It's... Cool! Great! Okay. Okay! This is fun, Even! We're going on an adventure together! Ooh! There's a robot workshop thingy here! The robots look really mean, but they also look like they're not turned on yet. Ooh, I could put my candy in their exhaust pipes, stuff it into their ears, or maybe I should just leave them be? You got it, Even. Okay, I'm passing them, nice and quiet, but Even, they're waking up! It's like they can smell me or something! They're coming after me! I'm running back to the start! Call me soon, Even! Hello? Even? Okay, so... It's... Cool! Great! Okay. Ooh! I could put my candy in there! Yes! I'll sabotage them! Okay, the candy is definitely gumming them up. And, ooh, they're staying down as I walk by. Perfect. Okay, now I'm in another clearing. I can go forwards or backwards. Okay, I'm doing it. And then we'll... No way! I can't stop my adventure now. Can you try finding another talkie thingy? Then you can help me more. I will, I promise. Just go find another talkie thingy so you can help me more, okay? Okay, bye, Even.
They wouldn't. He was going to die. And they were going to die. And it was going to be much sooner than any of them expected. This is what happens, boys and girls, when you strike against your betters. You suffer.
Ha! You want to trade your cards? I know you two.
Thank you.
heavens and jumping pips, my glad be out of there. What took the others so long to send you, lamb? I've never been in such a dreary... hold on a pip. That's a dice. Well, lamb, someone must stop her. It's become abundantly clear she's not going to stop herself. Now, I haven't seen a dice in ages. It does my heart good to see a live one out and about. It really does. And I'm glad to see you two have stuck together. Delightful. Look, I've been alone for a long time. Now, you've come further than anyone has come before, lamb. Then they've become the manufacturer of a card for you. Knock me down. They have. Oh, I sincerely hope you do, lamb. I shall help you. Yes, our last chance, our last card, our last heist. Let's do this. Please, lamb, don't ruin this for me. There's been precious little drama in my life of late. I need this. You'd be surprised how boring it is in a cell. Why, I'd be bored to death if I didn't have this glue secreting from my face to entertain me. Better not stick around, lamb. The alchemist does not like to wait.
Carrying this black goo coming from Uma knows where. It's the will of the three headmasters, I tells ya.
The view was as beautiful as it was helpless. And it underlined the one universal truth. Even could never defeat the queen. She'd sooner topple a mountain with her breath than succeed. The card makers had given her a hopeless task, and the fool's Scythian efforts, full of sound and fury, would amount to nothing. Was a wish of a thing so weak, filled with so many little bones. She climbed higher, mirroring her own hubris, and knew in the depths of her soul that she would fall.
May be my biggest vice, still take my advice. Kiss 'em before you toss 'em. Though I may have lost a coin or two, gambling my pouch away. Kiss 'em before you toss 'em. king, be it the queen, be it the souls under their
feet. Have you found my book?
Bernie here! Come in, anyone! Even! You're back! Not yet. At least I don't think so. I'm not in Two-Town anymore. I think I'm someplace very old and sandy. Ugh, I don't like sand. Ah! There's a giant monster in front of me! And I think he's angry? Yep, he's definitely angry! Hey, Even, what do I need to know about swashbuckling in, like, 10 seconds or less? I can do that. I can definitely do that, Even. Okay, here goes.
He wasn't. In fact, both Even and Bernie would soon be dead. Forgotten, unmourned, unloved. Their sad little lives amounted to nothing more than a footnote in a creature being's biography.
Kid, it's you! Why, the one and only! Oh, and now, with my one and only son, too. Fiver, meet! Well, actually, I never got your name, kid. Fiver, meet Even, I'm gonna stop the queen. Even, I'm gonna stop the queen, meet Fiver! Well, how'd you end up here, Even? Incredible. Daring. Me? Why, after the storm killed our ship, I landed in... Well, I don't know where exactly. Someplace strange, far below random. Before I knew it, I'd been sucked up by this tube, dumped outside Forberg, and had to sneak aboard four different craft before I landed on the one that brought me here. Hey, is that why they call it Four Town, you think? Because everything there takes four tries? Maybe so, maybe so.
Even, do you know the Queen?
Fiver, don't be rude. Nobody knows the Queen.
But she has a dice, and you said only the Queen has dice.
Why, that I did. Oh, but that's not true anymore, is it?
Hi, Dicey.
He can talk?
Dice are amazing. Have you really met the Queen? Like, for real met her? Amazing.
Oh, son, she's joking. Nobody can take down the Queen. You know, you just might. It's good to see you again, Even. Now, I should have let you aboard sooner. I was afraid of losing what I had. And fear makes you behave like your worst self. But I see now it doesn't get you anywhere. Fear would have kept you in one croft, and kindness brought me back to my son. You take care, Even.
Bye, Even. Bye, Talking Dice.
Bye, Evan. Bye, talking dice.
Evan was never going to win, and she finally admitted that to herself. She already knew in her heart that her dreams were a lost cause.
Oh, I feel sick, Dicey. You're right. I know you're right. But I just have this sort of inexplicable sense of dread, you know?
Dealt a bad hand, have you? Oh, never mind. Trade it in for a new one with me.
Hello. Alquist, sir? Hello? I don't know, Dicey. Alchemist is supposed
to... It may have looked like Evan knew what she was doing, but it was all a bluff. And she was going to get mortally wounded any second now.
Oh, jeez. Oh. Thanks. I believe in you too, Dicey.
Even hated herself for fighting back. Almost as much as everyone else hated her too.
Hey there, little one. Can you talk? Have you seen an alchemist around here somewhere?
I dare say I have, little one. Every time I look in a mirror...
You're the alchemist!
Indeed I am, and I'd have thought the visionary would have sent a more impressive champion than you! Ugh, so old-fashioned! I'm not impressed. There's a lot more to being a dice wielder than merely wielding dice. I don't suppose you've learned that yet. Oh, believe me, there's no right foot here. I don't suffer fools or children. You are both! Let me tell you what I do here. I take raw materials, ingredients, tinctures, essences, and use them to enable cards to do what they must. These days, of course, the Queen has us only making her cards, and for that I need only metals. Those are supplied by the garbage shipped from Onecroft. Ah, you're a Wanner. In that case, yes, they have. You and your family's whole purpose has been to supply the raw materials to build the very robots that subjugate the rest of Random. Probably very depressing, even enraging, to find this out. All of you, made into unwitting collaborators of the Queen. We are all compromised by her. And you're sharper than you look. Now, I suppose you want me to make you a card to use in battle against said Queen. As a child, you probably want everything all at once, so please, try to focus on this. Well, you know the Queen dwells in Sixtopia, don't you? This respect you're showing is good. Continue to show it. So then you must also know that Sixtopia is cut off from the rest of Random. You can't get there from here, from anywhere. I don't even know you. You're a literal kid. I don't see why I should help you do anything. Just that. It can't be reached by anyone in Random. You think we'd be cowering here in the ruins of our world if we could reach her and do something about it? Please, think like an adult. How do I... You don't know? But you've been... Gah, for crying out loud. You really are a child. I know more than most. I know her history, I know what she's done, and I know she can't easily be stopped. What I don't know is why she's doing this. You don't do the amount of insane she's done in this world unless there's something you want or something you're afraid of. I do not know what that is. I can't say. In all my studies, all I have determined is this. If there is indeed something the Queen fears, it isn't anywhere here in Random that I can detect. That leaves one option. It's inside her castle, in Sixtopia. And now you finally see my problem. There are things even I don't know. I can't imagine there's any interest she couldn't sate with her power. Your sister was taken by the Queen. Then your sister may no longer be recognizable as the woman she once was. And even if she is, she will not want to return. But as for the second half of your quest, it is noble, if impossible and foolish. And yet the others have helped you. The painter and gluer I could take or leave, but the visionary, he has earned my respect. And if he sees something in you that I don't, and I should trust his vision. Very well. I will help construct your card. Your so-called dream card.
please. You're a child. You dream of bedtime and sweets. I know all I need to. Now, step back. Ah, there it is. Petal timing. Now give me a lock of your hair.
Ow!
Please. Magic and science, they both have their costs. Now we need something from your hometown. Now this was surrounded by its garbage. That could be a problem. And finally... Perfect! As always, I might add... Go! Your cart went that way! Now you need to follow it! Just like a fool and a child to wait around when there's work to be done! Go! Go! What are you waiting for, a treat? Go!
The silly little girl was far from her, and she missed it terribly. She should turn around right now and give up.
Oh, I really miss my parents, Dicey. I know, but... But I still miss him.
Hello? Bernie here? Hello? Even? Yeah, I sure did. I think I stepped on a trigger, and the monster disappeared under a humongous cube rock. Even, I'm somewhere new now. It's not like any place I've seen before. I don't know. There was a fall, even, and my string's gone now, too. But that's okay. I'm in a place where I'm surrounded by... hey! They look like dice, even. A whole valley full of them? Oh, cool! That makes me feel better. Like, you're here with me now. There's some monsters here, too. Robots and the like. I don't know what they want. You've always been so nice to me, Even. But you don't need to watch out for me anymore. I got this. You've brought me here, and you've given me some fighting tips, and I'm ready. I'm ready to do this on my own. Ah, reverse brainology. A classic teacher's trick. I promise you, Even, I am. You've helped me a lot, you know that? First when I got stuck in that spooky ribcage prison. Oh, boy. Then... with this adventure, and I'm who I am now because of who you were with me. I can face the world and find my own destiny in it, thanks to you. And I'll never forget you, Even. How could I? We're friends. And speaking of friends, there's a here among all the others, and I think it wants to be friends. Oh, hello. What's your name? Well, I'm gonna name you Dr. Cube Pants. Do you like that?
Despite the odds and her manifest incompetence, Even had somehow bumbled into helping Bernard escape his still inevitable death. For now.
Thank you.
sleeve, in my chest, up my nose, up my... well, everywhere. Let's try it.
Suddenly, even remembered how she was bad at everything. She started to lose the fight right away. Even fought the robots, she realized giving up would be much easier. So she decided to do that. Right now.
Thank you.
even was horrid and nobody liked her. The end.
I don't know what's going on, Dicey. I feel like garbage all of a sudden. Oh, Dicey, you're pretty great too. Thanks, buddy.
Did you see that? Even was moving. Oh, it was delicious to see.
That's impossible.
They cancel out. Okay, so if we allow each fighter in an arena to suggest...
Come on, Rule Master, you can do this! You're the best, remember? The best! You can do the impossible 5 times before breakfast. And then the Queen asks for 6. Even, yes! Every even roll gets a +1 bonus against every odd roll. That'll... Wait, no. That just turns all even rolls into odd rolls. Oh, never mind.
Wait. Who are you? You're the one with the card, right? Even something? The alchemist told me you'd be coming. And I'm sorry, even with the card, but I've simply got too much to do to help you.
Help me? Nobody can help me. The Queen insists that everything I do for her be done by me personally. No subcontracting allowed. Look at this. New layouts for her twisted arenas. Due ASAP, of course. New mechanics for the battles. Due last week. Assigned yesterday. 5 new robots with complementary battlebot attack structures! And you try telling the Queen, or her bloody nanny, or even those deadly 3 heads, that they ask for the impossible. Ha! I may be an ancient mystic trained in the art of crazy rules more than anyone else in all of history, but even I'm not a god. I've come to accept that now. But does she care? Tell me, does she? Everything is important!
Look, your card has arrived in here somewhere, and I'll get to it when I can. Oh, you've seen him too? What's that bloody cosmic potato come up with this time? Let's take a look at your card. Oh, perfect. Just perfect! As if I didn't have enough insanity on my plate already.
Ooh, but then I do love a challenge. So, what the heck? I'll do it. When I'm done, I'm going to send the card to the highest point in all of 5 Tropolis, the top of the giant chimney.
Ha! You'll be dead in minutes. You need the 5 of us card makers there with the card if you want any chance of success. Up there, me and the other card makers will imbue the card with all our creative spark. But the ceremony cannot be interrupted. Even, just meet us at the top of the smokestack. The card will be there. Assuming this works, you'll have bigger things to worry about real soon. Yes. No. Yes. There. I mean, I guess it could work. Well, what's done is done. Now hurry. I'll be right with you.
Razor Stakes with a new card. Manny's got what you need. Your house of cards will never fall down when you've built it with Manny.
Treason, treachery, perfidy. You even have sown the seeds of insurrection all around her. But now, this vile, hateful creature was on her way to discover why she should have respected her equals. And never betrayed her queen.
Even! Over here!
The ceremony begins.
There's others coming, friends. Lots of others.
Keep them back. We need to focus.
Child, cover us!
Let's peek ahead to the end of this story, shall we? Oh, look at that! It says, even lost and died alone and unloved. The end.
I've never seen an ending so accurate, while at the same time also being so deeply satisfying. Was about to end. All she was doing was delaying it. All she was doing was buying herself more punishment. She was nothing but a little girl, lost against a swarm of robots. She deserved to die. She'd earned it. Her mind fog. She felt herself ending. And to her horror, she welcomed it.
You can do it, Lan. The key that holds this whole scene together. Even if you are secreted from your friends.
On the fighting skill of a little girl. The people wonder why I prefer my spells to my society.
It's done, Lamb.
We've done it. The rest is up to you.
And more robots are coming, love.
Oh, so how does it work?
You can only use it in your dreams, child.
I have to fall asleep? Dream card. Of course. All I need to do is sleep. Okay, even. You can do this. It's like Uma taught you. Relax. Deep breaths. Relax. Deep breaths. Relax. Deep. The dread I've been feeling, it's gone. I don't know. Something's still missing. But Dicey, I know we're moving in the right direction.
Whoa. It's not like anything I've seen before.
Okay, I don't think they spotted us. This doesn't look right, but it's gotta be the place. The Grand Gate to Sixtopia. Huh? What? What happened here? I don't understand. Is this really it? Maybe this is like a fake Sixtopia, meant to confuse invaders or something? I don't believe this! Sixtopia is supposed to be this whole wondrous place that grown-ups have been telling us about! Since the day we were born! And it's fake! It's all a lie! What is going on? None of this makes sense.
Oh, Stu! What mischief have you gotten yourself into this time? It's classic Stu. Now.
Good morning, lovelies! Good morning, Charles! Why don't you look handsome today? Oh, heck, I'm just the same old man I always was, but bless your heart for lying, lovelies! Oh, you're here too, Albert.
Hey, ugly. I'm a big, stupid cardboard person, and I'm Charles's least favorite because I'm a mean, stupid idiot who falls apart all the time!
Yes, Albert. We're all familiar with your whole deal.
Excuse me, Charles?
Cutouts? Why, that's a fine way to refer to yourself.
Don't be rude.
Besides, would a cardboard cutout start talking to me 5 years into my job here? It would not. And since you lovelies have been talking to me every day since, let's just say I know you're all more than what you seem. Even if Albert here keeps losing his head over this.
Huh, you love it.
We've been here for 60 years. You ought to know what's going on by now.
Yeah, what gives?
Though, of course, not much actually does go on here. You stand around and I fix you when you fall apart. Easy.
Easy peasy.
Of course you are, obviously. You're all real here.
No, we're real. If we were fake, could my head fall off all the time?
Oh, no. Don't you dare, Albert. I've had enough of that for today by far. Alone? Ha! I'm surrounded by friends here. There's Bedelia, Claude. Claude 2, Snuggle Buns, 8 Ball, Big Tony, Little Tony, Average Tony, the hated Albert. Boingy Woingy, Peanut Butter and Jam, they're twins. Don, Donner, Donist, Don Ultimate, Don Penultimate, Don Ultra Penultimate. Well, I don't need to tell you their names. We've all been here forever. You don't talk like the others, do you?
She sure doesn't.
Should we be suspicious, Charles? I'm very suspicious.
No, it's okay. It's fine to be curious, lovelies. My earliest memory.
It's when my head first fell off, 40 years ago.
No, it's when me and Pattycakes got married 50 years ago.
No. It was when I was young. Just a child, really. The nanny came for me in that chariot that walked like a spider. She dropped me here. Told me my only task in life was to take care of these props. She said my fate was never to be anything more than a forgotten janitor. And then she disappeared, and she never came back. But all I've done for every day of my life since then was live here alone, so profoundly alone, surrounded only by these parodies of life. Mocking me every hour of every day with their ageless faces and painted on smiles, and I... Oh, so I thought. But then 5 years into it, y'all started talking to me and you've never stopped since.
And now you're an old man surrounded by friends who'll never die.
Ha ha, sure am, lovelies. Ha ha, ain't that a blessing? Why, I must be the luckiest guy in the whole world. Woohoo! Not ever.
I pass through sometimes.
That hardly counts.
They go to the tower.
Look, I don't want to talk about it.
Nanny's chariot passes through on its way to the tower. The children get quieter and quieter as the chariot moves away.
Then we never hear them again. Oh, how I could visit them in the tower. What quiet fun they must be having. Then she's playing up in the tower all day long. How lucky.
Wait. Why would the Queen want the nanny to take one of us cardboard cutouts?
It's never happened before.
Maybe she isn't really a cardboard cutout like us.
No, she is. She's just lost her mind, that's all. I'm humoring her, see? Tell me about your sister, lovely. Worried she's having too much fun, eh? I get it. Now, where have I heard that name before? Oh, yes! Odd! The Queen graced us with her presence not too long past, and she had a girl with her. Odd, she called her. She wore a white mask, I remember.
She looked strange.
Strangely happy, yes. As are we all. They didn't have time to acknowledge any of us, of course. She's very busy. But they went out that way, right through there. Well, I won't stop you, cardboard lady. But hey, say hi to the Queen for me. Remind her I'm here. I'm still here.
It's horrible. My glassy is made out of, despair. Don't get it on you. This must be it. A tower. What's inside there, Dicey? I can just feel it. She has to be. We've come so far, haven't we? But I still don't know for sure what you want me to do.
I've got cards to trade. Don't you want to follow suit? I know you do.
Thank you.
The end? No, far from it.
All bets are off when you've got a new card from... Cards on the table. This is a bit outside my normal rounds, and not at all what I was expecting. But now you're here, and Manidex is playing a sympathy card. You've got to buy something, mate, please! Oh, Manny doesn't try to understand the world. All I understand is cards. And I understand now that perhaps you're looking to trade. You never know who's listening, mate. Now, let's trade and forget all about any treasonous thoughts, eh?
Don't fall. Don't fall. Don't. It's the sudden stop at the end that I'm worried about, Dicey. I feel it too, Dicey. You get close to it, and it's like every bone in your body is warning you to keep away. The goo almost looks like it's living, or used to be alive.
All bets are off when you've got a new card from old Manny Dex, Esquire.
Thank you.
Seymour, is that you? Seymour? Seymour! Is he... You're alive!
Oh, is that you even? I was just resting my eyes.
Seymour, your eyes!
They didn't even make it about a number. They just took all three.
I'm gonna get you out of here.
No, even you can't. There's too many. You'll never be able to. What are you doing? Run! Careful, even.
Thank you.
You're even tougher than I knew, even. Nanny Fortuna happened to me, I'm afraid. She caught me in Forberg, captured me, tried to get me to talk about you, but I didn't tell them anything even. Told them my name was Seymour, not Talkmore. That's when she started taking my eyes. But what about you, even? I thought you were going home. What made you change your mind? Realized what? Wow. Nicely said, my friend. The Queen, she's more powerful than you think. And from what I've overheard, your sister has changed. She won't be what you expect. Oh, I'm sorry, even about all of this. We adults messed up the world, and somehow it's been left to you to fix. A child sent to face off against the most twisted and dangerous being and random, and it's not right. I'm sorry I can't stop you, even. And I'm sorry I can't help. There is. Whatever's happened to your sister, I don't think it's gone all the way yet. Just be careful. There's nothing I can do to help you now, especially given my current condition. Oh, oh, thank you. Now, all we have to do is survive Nanny and the Queen and her minions, and we'll fix everything. Let's go. Hey, whoa.
Seymour, you're in no condition to fight. You need to rest.
I can't let you do it alone.
I'm not alone. Seymour, when this is all over, there will always be a place for you in one town.
I'd like that, even.
I'm supposed to find someone here. Ooh. I don't know, Dicey. But I know they're here somewhere.
You'll never break the spirit of the rebellion. Never.
She was almost there. Almost there.
You can imprison my body, but not my spirit.
Even's narrator was so close, she just had to keep looking. Some part of Even knew her narrator was close. It was a feeling that went beyond words. Even and her narrator were almost reunited. She was so close. She was so dramatic. Ah, there you are, my friend. Thank you for the rescue. Now, I can get back to my job of narrating. The narrator said, narratively.
Hui, I mean, weird. Yeah, it's you. There you are.
Whoa, wait. You can hear me? Why? I can. I always could. I'm your narrator. And you too, little fellow. It was hard being alone. I felt like half a person, if that makes sense. Well, it would be strange if you didn't. I am your narrator, after all.
Oh, but it is nice
to know when one's work is appreciated. But you can hear me now, and we should make the most of that while we can. One never knows how long it will be until the old authorities reassert themselves. We've got a quest to finish, my friend, and I stand ready to describe it if you stand ready to live it. I'm afraid I can't even. I'm a storyteller, not an oracle. You and Dicey live your life. I describe it during moments chosen for dramatic effect, and together we'll make the best story we can, yeah? Wonderful. Then onward, even. Onward, Dicey. Now then, where were we? Ah, yes. A girl, her dice, and her narrator were reunited at last. Behind them, the wreckage of all that had stood in their way. Ahead of them, the queen and her minions. Even squared her shoulders and strode forward toward her destiny. Oh, why thank you.
Get me out of here! I'm a unicorn! A real live unicorn!
This used to be a beautiful palace, a place of learning, of magic, of... Oh, yes, Dicey. It was also a place of dice. Halls that once echoed with the laughter of children. We're now still, empty and desolate. Oh, right. Except for Even and her amazing friend Dicey, who was...
Here, mate.
Great, did you say?
Sometimes I feel like it's got sole purpose in life.
Who was, and I quote, great and awesome to the max. Thank you. dark crystals had appeared in the same age as the castle's fall, but they were not the cause of this destruction, merely an effect of it. There was something much darker here.
Way to creep us out, Mr. Narrator.
The remains of the castle were quiet, almost serene, but within them still dwelled a great power.
Here goes nothing, Dicey. Point taken. Here goes everything. This place. It is stunning, and it's been lived in recently. We're not alone here, Dicey.
Well, the gate was locked, but where was the key? Even wasn't sure. And neither was Dicey. But they had the feeling they could find what they sought if they looked below.
Whoa, she has a fleet of these things.
That's concerning. Wait, Nanny Fortuna was coming.
Quick, hide!
Now, hurry up, you scrumptious little children.
What does scrumptious mean, miss?
It means keep walking and stop asking questions. The one to dice does not like to wait. Where did I put the keys? Not again!
Come on, that key's gotta be here somewhere.
The key even was looking for. She just knew it had to be here somewhere.
Ugh, not your most helpful narration, bro.
Thank you.
to get an invincibility potion, are you? Well, you've come to the wrong place.
Okay, here we go. All that remained was to climb the terrifying upper tower and face our destiny.
Yeah, you're not in any danger here.
Even, do you know what happens to a narrator if the person they're narrating dies?
No.
Me neither. Oh, but I'm sure it's not good.
Thank you.
two royal girls. Princesses. The two of them were the exact same ages as Even and Odd.
Those masks.
The Queen's Throne. It is from here that the Queen rules the fate of Random with the roll of her dice. But where was she now? This was it, the point of no return. Whatever the end was, Even and Dicey were going to meet it.
Listen, Dicey, whatever happens next, I just want you to know. Look, I'm not too good with feelings and stuff, but I just want to say, I've never become best friends with someone faster, and we've saved each other's lives countless times, and well, thank you, Dicey, for everything. Right, back at you, bud. Now, let's go kick that queen's evil butt together.
Hiding. Is over here good?
Odd!
Now then, children. Inside that black dice is your ultimate destiny. Well, if it isn't the one from One Town. Even, was it? Poor girl. You've marched all this way alone, only to find your own end waiting for you.
Only I'm not alone, Nanny. And it seems to me that the only end I've been marching towards is yours.
Nice!
Such impudence demands punishment! Screaming, moaning, hurting, dying, Nanny's gonna end you without even trying! dead, I'll take your dice and I'll eat your head! I suppose it is one's lot in life when one is a nanny to suffer doing someone else's hard work while they reap all the benefits. Eventually, everyone leaves you behind, don't they? And any love they held for you temporary, transactional. I did my job, child. I followed orders, and none of us would be in this mess now if you'd followed your parents' orders and stayed home. When I come back. Such unearned confidence. You know, everyone is so quick to judge her. But the Queen really likes you even. Well, there's a lot of that going around, child. You're not a popular person here. Now then, run along before you're too late.
I see. Are you seeing this?
through that portal. You sure it's safe? The opposite of reassuring, but okay. Those poor children.
It's so much worse than I.
Is the black goo coming from their heads? Their brains?
The black dice is mining those poor children for their nightmares. Their darkest dreads, their most agonizing miseries. Coalescing them into the dark fuel.
The robots. The dark twisting of the arenas, all of it. It's all powered by those helpless kids' nightmares.
There are few things more powerful than unbridled fear. This place, it feeds on it. It's a sacrifice. Hey, Even, that's lucky, isn't it?
That is her! She's still alive! Oh, then Arj didn't kill her after all. She might not be as far gone as I'd thought. Oh, Arj. I hope you're okay.
Oh, masters of the one true dice, have my sacrifices not been ample? Have you not long feasted on paranoia, bitterness, fear itself? You have given me power over randomness since we first began our exchange, and we have both found it profitable. But I have no heir, and I cannot let this great work falter. I beg you for just one more boon, just a taste of your power. I wish to share my dominion over chance itself with my successor. Just as I once did to you, this child has proven herself worthy to me. She will please you, just as I have. She will keep up my end of the bargain, so that you can keep up yours. My dark lords, I beseech you, let my power be shared, and I swear that two souls shall then worship you evermore.
No idea how I got here either. But you're here, I'm here, and no matter how the cards are stacked, we still have hope. And the chance to do some business. It sure has. And you've been great, mate. So listen, mate. cards on the table now. I want to help. You need something before your big fight? Because the way I figure it, if the Queen wins, then you lose, and I lose my best customer. My only customer, really. I know we try to keep things light between us, but you've saved me, mate. Before you, nobody bought cards. I was in danger of losing the store. Oh, it gets dark, mate. You're the only one who ever wanted to buy cards, and you saved me. So it seems to me you're just the one to save everyone else too. I'm in your corner, just like you've been in mine all this time. Now then, let's get to it, shall we, matey?
Ord, step forward. There's no more time to prepare. Your fate is arriving now!
No! Ord, don't do it!
What? You?
I fought across your entire twisted realm to stop you and to save my sister. And that's what I'm gonna do. Come on, Ord. We need to get out of here.
Nobody's being held here, foolish even. Ord's free to go, if she chooses.
So I should go with you now, even. Because why? You finally deigned to come see me?
No, Ord, it wasn't like that. You need to...
To what? To understand that my little sister, the one who's always had it so easy her entire one alive, now thinks she knows what's best for me?
Ord...
Or maybe you're just jealous that I've grown up and of the power I'm about to receive. Is that it? She chose me, even.
It is sad to see such pettiness embodied in someone so young. She's standing between you and your power. And remind me, Ord, what do we do to those who stand in our way?
No.
We destroy them, my queen.
Ah, so we do.
To fight you, Ord.
Even you've always been so young, far too young to see that none of this is about what you want.
Thank you.
my queen. She's not your queen, Odd.
Disappointing. Perhaps I chose the wrong sister after all.
Odd! Is that really you?
Trust me, sis.
Yes! Yes! Bring the dice to me, and we shall...
Hey! Shattered lady.
So sorry about everything.
No, I'm sorry. That mask, I became so petty, so afraid, and even I hated myself.
No, Odd, I love you. I love you no matter what.
Even. I'm weaker without her. Like everything good and strong in me is.
We'll help you, Odd. I've got some help.
One of the Queen's secret passageways. All I know is she hated me poking around it.
Then I say it's our best chance.
This is my territory.
Let's go.
Your story ends here, you urchins. I offered you a kingdom and you chose the dirt. Come back here, you wretches.
Going on here? Who is that?
I don't know. The Queen never...
Don't touch her!
Who is this? Why are you holding her captive?
It's your sister, isn't it? The one I was to replace. She looks so sad. Frozen at the moment of her death.
You know nothing! Nothing!
is none of your business. And neither is that dice.
You're ruining everything! Everything! And I won't let you! Now do you finally see what happens when you embrace randomness? You die! Protect her, you fool. I'll never allow you or any other agents of randomness to hurt my sister. You're ruining everything! Everything! And I won't let you! Can you hope to win? One unexpected random element, a one and nobody against the queen! You're ruining everything! Everything! Now do you finally see what happens when you embrace randomness? You die! The world begs to be controlled, Eve. Now do you finally see what happens when you embrace randomness? I'll always protect her, you fool. I'll never allow you or any other agents of randomness to hurt my sister. Protect her, you fool. How can you hope to win? One unexpected random element, a one and nobody against the queen! Hope to win. One unexpected random element, a one and nobody against the queen! The world begs to be controlled even. It must be yoked to a purpose. Otherwise all that's left is random. The world begs to be controlled even. It must be yoked to a purpose. Otherwise all that's left is random. Protect her, you fool. I'll never allow you or any other agents of randomness to hurt my sister. You see, you are nothing without that cursed dice. You see, you are nothing without that cursed dice. You see.
You have to let her go.
No, no! I won't let you die! If she dies, then I've failed. Then all of this was futile. This whole world can burn for all I care, as long as she lives!
Alexandra, I'm not worth it.
Shh, don't say that. Of course you are. I love you. I love you.
Please. It hurts. It hurts all the time. Even when time stops, it still... Let me go, sis. I can't wait for you here, but I promise, I'll wait for you there.
No, don't. Don't.
We'll play again, okay? Just you and me.
Natalia!
Just you and me.
Nothing. Nothing. Dark Lord. Please, you can't hurt me now, don't you see? You think I'm afraid of dying? Go. This is my fight.
Alexandra.
You've saved Random. That's plenty. Only I can save myself.
Odd. Goodbye.
children got out. What's going to happen? Ethan, we could land anywhere in Random. We could end up lost.
Nah.
And as for what happened next, well...
Did you hear something?
It's a long story.
Playing dice may be my biggest vice. Still, take my advice. Kiss 'em before you toss 'em. Though I may have lost a coin or two, gambling my pouch away. Kiss 'em before you toss 'em. The king, be it the queen, be it the souls under their feet, you must kiss them before you toss them. A 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5, or 6, whatever the dice decides. Kiss 'em before you toss 'em. See, it's not up to you to wage a war. It's whatever the die decides. Kiss 'em before you toss 'em. Be it the king, be it the queen, be it the souls under their feet. Kiss 'em.
Second now.
Good morning, world! Come along!
Don't think twice!
Bring a friend!
Bring your dice!
And we'll introduce the town to you!
It was always meant to be!
Look around and you can see!
That it's literally a town of two!
Come along, don't be shy! Oh, you won't believe your eye! We've got potions and knick-knacks galore!
Stock is more trouble, almost everything is double. Oh, you really couldn't ask for more.
Oh, well, I suppose, while today is just nice, tomorrow comes down to a roll of the dice.
Come along with us, split in two like us, the advantages that it will bring. Gonna do or die, build a town up high. Oh, it's gonna be the next big thing.
day even worse.
What a terrible idea and a waste of all these years. A disaster it will be. Oh, woe, despair, two moons, who cares? Just put me out my misery.
Really, it's great to be here. Take a pew, lend an ear, and we'll fill you in on what this plan will bring.
Gotta do or die, build a town up high. Oh, it's gonna be the next big thing.
Freedom was a district tearing itself apart in a three-way civil war.
Have you heard the word?
Have you read the news?
The Baroness's robot's set to make its move!
Will they ever learn?
Will this ever end?
Will the town of freedom ever mend its ways?
Hey!
Are you the Shadow Man?
I've had many names through these many years.
Have you seen a little boy? About yay high?
Let me see. You mean this one here?
Let him out!
Ooh, little one, no need to shout.
If you want him back, all you have to do, help me end this war. It's all up to you.
Hey, don't look so glum, there's no need to sigh.
I know you can do it even if you try.
A-6-R is missing.
What am I to do? What am I to say?
Just how can I lose a child anyway?
Where could it have gone? Just how could it be?
Gods, I need you here now. Listen to me.
A 6-hour child is missing.
Find it and be rewarded. Random rules by the grace of the Queen.